Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to see the various manufacturing processes of plastic products. In this video tutorial, we are going to cover various types of plastics, injection molding process, thermoforming or vacuum forming, blow molding process, rotational molding process, compression molding, resin transform molding, reaction injection molding, or you can say RIM. Before going to start, we should have to first understand what is mold. It is an assembly of core half and cavity half containing the part impression into which plastic material is injected and cooled to produce the internal and external shape of the molding. That is called as the mold. So for any manufacturing process going to start, first we should have to understand some points like which type of manufacturing processes we have to produce that product, which material we are using for the mold, what are the design guidelines for making a mold, what are various types of materials used for the products and its advantages and disadvantages. So all these points we should have to remember before going to manufacture any product or selection of any manufacturing process. First of all, we have to see the types of plastics. Plastic, it is nothing but a resin and it's having the types like the two types of plastics, thermoplastic and thermoset plastic. Thermoplastic are the recyclable plastic and thermoset plastic are not the recyclable plastic. The basic properties of types of material we are going to see in next video. Now, first of all, we are going to see the injection molding process. In injection molding process, first is about the material selections. Selection of mold materials. The selection of mold material is based on the properties of the steel, like the high compression strength combined with the sufficient toughness, about the low distortion and size changing during the heat treatment. Third point, about the good machining ability. Fourth one is the ability to take mirror finish, that means the polished surface, you can also called as the mirror image. Fifth point is about the ability to resist the corrosion for aggressive chemicals and substance of the plastic material. So these are the basic properties of steel. According to that, we are chosen the materials. For example, core and cavity insert or sprue bush, local inserts, lifter inserts and sliders, we are mostly preferred, that is material is the P20. For the top plate and bottom plate, ejector and retainer plate, parallel block, core and cavity housing, all these are made from the C45 because we are not required more strength, so that we are using C45 due to the economy point of view. Next, a locating ring and support pillar. We are using MS, that is the mild steel. Guide pillar, guide bush, ejector guide pillar and ejector guide bush. All we are using EN31 and EN32. EN nothing but the English number. Wear plate and guide rail are made from the OHNS. OHNS, it is the oil hardening non-shrinking steel. Due to the dimensional stability we can achieve, so OHNS we are used for these plates. Ejector pins, return pin and dowel, made from the EH-13. That is, it is the hardened steel. A lifter rod and finger pin, it is made from the EN-31. And pulling Allen bolts, pulling channel, Allen bolts, plugs, circular clips and O-rings. All these are the standard materials we are taking from the market directly to reduce the cost. Because when we purchase any standard part from the market, it will reduces the cost. We are going to overview about what is the injection molding process. In injection molding process, the plastic material is fed from the machine hopper. When it travels through a heated cylinder where it mixed in a flowable condition and injected into the mold by means of a ram or the screw ram, the molten material completely fills the mold cavity. Then it cools to solidify and is ejected from the mold as a finished article. Injection molding has the features like ability to process high mass production operations. That means number of components we can produce at a time. Ability to make the highly complex shapes in a single operation. It is very flexible due to the plastic material we are using. So we can make the complex shapes of the components. Again, the ability to produce molded parts with higher dimensional stability, or you can say the accuracy. That's why the injection molding process having high price due to maintaining the accuracy or preciseness in the components. The shot capacity in a single stroke and uniformly hitting capacity of material in pounds per hour of injection molding machine are determined by the maximum amount of GPPS, it is the general purpose polystyrene material, that can be processed by the machine. The mold must be maintained before softening temperature of the material being molded. It is controlled by circulating cold water, oil and electric cartridge heaters. Injection molding machine is used to produce the automotive, electrical, electronics, household, industrial, medical, plastic and components, etc. So this is the just basic overview of the injection molding process. If you have any issues related to the process, then please comment me so that I will give the reply to your questions. Here you can see on the image the flowchart of the injection molding process, how it works. Main is the mold loading on the machine. We have just seen it is the two half. One is the fixed half and other one is the movable half. Once our mold is made, then we just load it is on the machine. Then we are closing the mold. After that, material metering into the hopper. We are inserting the raw materials into the hopper. Then material injection, and it is heated inside it into the molten material. Then holding the pressure, and once the mold flow is injected, it holds the pressures and it cools. Once it is cool, then mold will be open. Mold opening here and ejected the part. And again, the cycle becomes start, that is from the mold closing point of view. That is, it is the cycle. So in such a way that injection molding process works. Now here we are going to see the hot runner system. You can see the image on the screen. The electric heater are already inserted into the insulated runner and insulation is also provided. So the material becomes heated inside the mold, that is called as the hot runner system. Cavity and molded part you can see here, and mold separates from the bottom line. A hot runner system is an assembly of heated components used in plastic injection molds that inject molten plastic into the cavities of the mold. The main task of the manifold is to distribute the plastic entering the mold to the various nozzles you can see in the image. The heater or electric heaters are inserted into these four insulated runners. Now we are going to see the basic injection molding machine. You can see the image on the screen. That is the basic injection molding machine. We are going to see the anatomy or the part names of the injection molding machine. We are start from the, that is the screw motor drive. It rotates. There is the hopper, and you can see in the hopper the raw material is already added. Sometimes it should be granular form or sometimes it is in the powder form. It depends which type of plastic we are using. Most of the times polycarbonate, PC or PP which we are using, then it is in the granular form. After molten material you can see, and heaters are also available at the bottom so that it is heated in the circular area. Heaters are already available, so the molten material will not becomes solidified inside. It provides the heat to the molten material to maintain the flowability of the plastic. Reciprocating screw is available there, and that complete system is called as the barrel. And here is the nozzle. That nozzle is the hole of the nozzle, and the screw bush becomes aligned. When we are going to the mold making, at that time each and individual parts of the mold we are going to see in the details. Here you can see the tie bar, then stationary platen. You can see here is the mold cavity, that means the cavity here inside, and the mold core. Cavity, it is nothing but the concave shape, and the core is the convex shape, like that. The movable platen is also there, so it moves. Rear platen you can see, clamping bar is there, or at the center you can see section view has taken already, that is the ejection bar. Ejection bar, it is used to eject the components. Ejection system, in the ejection system ejection pins are also included, and the mold parts. So this is just the basic injection molding machine view. We are going to see in details about the mold constructions, its material, its specification, all the things in detail in the next video.